Tomorrow at 10 a.m., you will have a chance to hear the stories of these three remarkable women, so I hope that you attend, and we welcome them to the conference. And now I'd like to introduce Anna Pinczuk, Vice President of Engineering at Cisco. Anna will discuss the Anita Borg Technical Leadership Award.
Thank you, and I'm delighted to be here on behalf of Cisco to present the Technical Leadership Award. We at Cisco love to celebrate our technical women. We also love to celebrate with technical women. The Anita Borg Award for Technical Leadership was established to recognize outstanding leaders who embrace Anita Borg's lasting vision to change the world for women and for technology. Nominees are women who have inspired the women's technology community through outstanding technological and social contributions. Through her leadership, the recipient has increased the impact of women on technology. Each nomination should demonstrate how the nominee's work has covered new ground, and her technical leadership has increased women's impact, representation, and effectiveness in the technology arena. This award comes with a $10,000 cash prize.
This year's winner is Ruzena Bajcsy. She's professor of EE, Electrical Engineering at the University of California, Berkeley, where she's also director emerita of the Center for Information Technology Research for the Interests of Society, which is often called CITRIS. Over the past four decades, Dr. Bajcsy has had an astounding impact in the field of active vision, computer vision algorithms for medical imaging and telepresence. She has pioneered new research field, guided natural policy regarding and leading the computing community in addressing social issues. She has broken barriers and opened up access for women as a role model, mentor, and advocate. She was also the general chair for the 1997 Grace Hopper Conference, and so for me, has been a role model and very supportive ever since I took over ABI. I hope that you hear her speak tomorrow at 1:45 p.m. Please welcome Ruzena Bajcsy, the Anita Borg Technical Leadership Award winner.
But as a professor, I cannot be speechless. So. thank you very much. I am very honored. And in fact, it really brings memories. Just to mention to you that the second Grace Hopper conference had about 100, it was jointly run by Fran Allen and myself, and had about 100 participants, and three men, I remember them as today. They were standing behind, you know, in the row, and one of them was from the National Science Foundation. I think Telly and all of us, we should be really proud when I look in this audience that all the young people and middle and old are here. The number 1,600 participants is remarkable. I like to say a few words to those of you who can be my grandchildren, and all of you who are below 30 can be my grandchildren. I lived through the Second World War, and as some of you know, I lived in Central Europe, so I experienced Hitler, and I also experienced Stalin. So I really deep down appreciate democracy and freedom in this country. But with that comes also responsibility. And I am very concerned that perhaps my generation, because we went through hardship, we have tried to make life for our children better and easier, and created, to a certain extent, the me generation. I am very hopeful when I talk to my grandchildren and my students that you folks have become much more concerned about the environment, about the social justice and sharing, and less selfishness. In California, we are experiencing a real hardship because the me generation doesn't want to share, doesn't want to pay taxes, and subsequently our education suffers. So my take-home homework for you grandchildren is tell your parents, don't be selfish. Thank you.